It's like a crime scene.
Just look at somewhere.
All of that.
It's 7:17 in the morning, the last morning with my hair. It's a tough day. I don't want to wake up. I don't want to start my day because I know how it's going to end with all of this gone. Do you realize how long it took me to grow this? It's been a wild ride. It's been a fun ride. Today at 1 p.m., it's gone. I'm going to take you along for the ride today. Just be my emotional support. I'm sad.
If any of you guys listen to the Junk Drawer, then you've heard the hair updates throughout the year.
I hate to say it, but I've got a hair update.
Oh, no.
The saga has taken yet another turn. Obviously, where we last left it, my wife said I could keep my hair if I did certain chores around the house. I did those chores, thus my hair is still here. But I've never been more productive than that weekend where she said I had to get this, this, and this done.
My wife wanted my hair cut back in August, and I somehow was able to keep it going.
My other back of the week, and guys, I, you know, normally I lead the show with this.
Don't tell me.
Guys.
It's not the hair, is it?
The appointment is set for Friday at 1 p.m.
No! Come on. Look at how far you've made it.
Oh, and I know. Like, I'm ready, but I'm not ready.
Really, my wife wants it more than I do. And then, you know, marriage. Let this be a lesson to any young couples out there. You guys, do everything your wife tells you. like an idiot, I set my appointment right in the middle of March Madness games. So let that be another lesson. But this is it. This is the end. Hey.
What you doing?
Filming a video about my hair.
Are you going to get your haircut?
Yeah.
When?
Right now.
Where are you going?
You want to say hi? This is the reason my hair is getting cut. So you guys have her to thank. Anything you want to say?
I think you're gonna look great.
You don't think I look great now?
No, I don't. I'm sorry. I don't think your hair looks good. All right. You're gonna miss the appointment because you're filming me.
I think she's on to me.
Driving there right now, and I'm just like in my feelings hard right now. Feels like the end of the school year, you know? Only at the end of this school year, you're moving and never going to see any of your friends ever again. My hair is my friends right now in that analogy. It's just like, I don't think women understand the bond guys create with their hair when they grow it out long. Like sure, like yeah, like certain rock stars and Charlie Whitehurst and I think Haley Joel Osment at one time. Like yeah, they all have long hair, but for the most part, you know, just the social norm is guys tend to keep their hair short. When a guy strays from that and starts to grow his hair out longer, he becomes attached to it. Going into all of this, I didn't have a plan that I'm gonna go a whole year without cutting my hair. There was no plan whatsoever. The longer my hair grew, I think the more attached I got to it. If you guys have been following Cork Bats, then you've definitely been following the growth of my hair. So I don't even know why I'm wearing a hat right now. I should just let it flow. I just got here, and you're probably wondering like, oh, where are you even getting your hair cut? Like some hoity-toity salon? Or maybe you're wondering like, oh no, I bet he goes to those hair salons where it's good to be a guy. No, not going there either. Bad experience, that place. No, I'm just going to some local haircut place. I think it's just for guys. Yeah, it's just a guy's haircutting place. Cause I'm a guy. What's up? Masculinity, let's go. All right, so I'm gonna do this. My hair does look kind of gross. I'm like so sad. So wait, when was my last haircut?
2/10 of 20.
2/10.
I would have given you all of my heart, but that someone is torn it apart.
The look on your face, I just can't read it yet.
It's sad. I'm crying. The first cut is the deepest. Baby, I know the
first cut is the deepest. Is this feeling better? No, it's not. You've been crying, it's okay.
I cried so much this morning. I don't know if I have any tears left in my body. So this is Joe. Joe, how long have you been styling hair?
I have been with a hair salon. It's going to be 9 years in September.
9 years. That's why yeah. She's so good. Joe is the last person to cut my hair over a year ago. February 10th.
February 10th.
Right then, how many times in your 9 years has someone waited 13 months between haircuts?
Less than one hand.
Okay, all right.
Joe did a great job. I did a good job of not crying. I will say this, one of the cool things about the place I got my hair cut at is they do give you a beer. So I think I earned this beer more than any other beer in my entire life. If I'm getting my hair cut after a year, over a year of growing it, I think the least I should get out of it is a beer. So, and yeah, it may be like a Friday afternoon, but I'm still gonna drink this beer.
Thanks for coming on this journey with me, guys. I appreciate it. Just knowing I have the support of the cool kids really helps.
I hope my wife is happy. Little does she know I'm gonna go another 13 months without cutting my hair. What?